Are you looking to jump into Facebook ads? Before you get started, please do yourself a favor and set up your Facebook Business Manager. In this video, my buddy Cedric is gonna show you how to set one up and show you also how to verify your domain, which is super important nowadays. We got lots to cover, so Cedric, take it away.
Thanks, Julian. Hey, my name is Cedric, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to create and set up a Facebook Business Manager. But before we get into that, I just want to take a brief moment to talk about the main difference between Business Manager and Ads Manager, because I know that a lot of people get these two confused. So let's start with Ads Manager. So I'm sure if you're watching this video, you're somewhat familiar with it, right? That's where you go to create a campaign, create your audience and your ads. But Business Manager is a little bit different. So Business Manager is where you go to just manage your overall business. So this is where you can connect and add a Facebook page, an Instagram account. You can add all your different ad accounts that your business potentially manage, your audiences, your pixels, your payments. So all the sort of information that would be more tied to your business. So it's not really, oh, should I have one or the other? Really, I personally think that all businesses should have a business manager, and then you should add your ad account right inside your business manager. So hopefully that clears up any questions that people have between these two sort of like, tools. And I just want to clear that up before I show you how to create a business manager. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do to create your business manager is head to business.facebook.com. So I'm gonna copy this and I'm gonna head to business.facebook.com. All right, now because I already have a business manager created, you can actually see I have more than one. I see this, so if you don't have one created yet, you're gonna see something like this. Okay, so you're gonna see this page, and if you are logging into your Facebook, which you should, because your business manager should be connected to your actual Facebook profile, you won't see the login here. You're just gonna see create account, right? So you actually don't wanna see the login button. You need to be logged in into your Facebook profile. So you're gonna create the button where it says create account, and it's gonna bring you and show you something like this. So it's gonna say create your business manager account. So I'm gonna call this demo and FB for Facebook. And I'm gonna put in my email, and I'm just gonna say plus. So the reason I'm adding the plus FB demo, it's not actually my email. It's just because if I receive any emails from Facebook regarding this business manager, I'll know to kind of just disregard it because it's a demo account. So I'm gonna click submit. Perfect. So now they just sent an email to, they just sent me an email. So I'm going to go in my Gmail and just verify my email. Okay, I just verified my email. So they sent me an email, looks like something like this, and I click the confirm now button and it brought me here. So if you've been following, congrats, you just created your business manager. But we're not done here. There's some other things that you need to set up just to make sure that you're set up for success. So we're gonna click here on business tools, and we're gonna click on business settings, which we're actually already on that page now that I'm realizing that. And we're gonna click on pages. And what you wanna do is you wanna add your Facebook page, you wanna add your ad account, and you also wanna add your Instagram account. So with Facebook page, all you have to do is click add, and then there's gonna be three options. The first option is to add a page, and you're gonna click this option is if you are the owner of the page and you know that there's not another business manager that have already claimed that page in the past. Or option number two here is if you're requesting a page. So this is what we usually do because we're an agency, and when we wanna work with a client, we usually request access to their Facebook page. We request access to their ad account, and we request access to their Instagram account. So we as an agency would pick this option. And honestly, if you're watching this video and you're like, hey, I don't have a Facebook page, I don't have anything, I'm just, you know, I'm learning about all this stuff at the moment, well, you would wanna click here to create a new page because you need a Facebook page in order to advertise on Facebook. So now we would go here under ad account, and we same thing that you did for the Facebook page, you wanna add your ad account. And it's really the same question. So do you currently have an ad account? All right, are you currently running ads? Or maybe you're not running ads, but you've created one in the past, then you'll want to bring that ad account in here. If you're requesting access because, I don't know, you're an agency or you want to work on someone else's ad account, then that's how you would do it. And if, again, you don't have an ad account, you can click the button here. Now, in order to add your own ad account, you're going to want to click here, and it's going to ask you for the ad account ID. And it's the same thing if you're requesting an account from someone else. It's always going to ask you for the account ID. Now, you might ask, like, how do I get and where do I go to get this ID? So you're gonna go in Ads Manager. So this is one of my demo account. And this is where the ID is. So it's right here. If you want an easy way to copy paste this ID, it's also in a URL. So if you look at campaigns, ACT stands for account. And then we have our ID right here. So you can Control C and then just put in the account ID here and you click on add account. One thing worth mentioning is that when you create a business settings, when you create a business manager, it's a different entity than you are. So even if you, let's say you're the only, I mean, you're the founder of your company and you don't have any employees, and you create this business manager here, you would still need to add yourself as a user for the page, the ad account and the Instagram account and any other things, because it's really, if you add an ad account, it's your business that owns it and not you. So you wouldn't be able to make changes on with your profile. Let me show you this example. So now I am in my Facebook Business Manager. And if we navigate to add accounts here, let's go into the demo account. Well, I can add people. And if ever I'm adding like the ad account for the first time in my Business Manager, I would need to add myself. So under name right here, I would be able to select myself and then because again, I'm the owner of this ad account. Well, I would want to give myself full control, and I would check this, and then automatically it checks everything, and then I can just assign it to myself. So you see, it's kind of weird because I'm the owner, but I'm also the owner of business of this business manager. But you need to assign users to ad accounts, to pages, and to your Instagram accounts, even if you're the owner. And that's just not kind of the way it works, but it's great because if you're working with an agency and, or maybe you're not working with them yet and you want them to, or they want to give you an audit, right? They want to audit your ad account and see how they could potentially help out reach your goals. Well, you might not want to give them full control. You might want to give them like view access. So this is why it's kind of set up that way. So just keep in mind that your business manager and your personal profile are like two different entities. And when you add an ad account to your business manager, you also got to go into the people here and give yourself access to the ad account. So you can, create campaigns, publish ad sets, and create ads. Now, hopefully this makes sense. Now what I wanna do is show you how to add your billing info. And after that, I'm gonna show you how to verify your domain. So stick until the end, because especially verifying your domain is really, really important. And that's something that you really need to do properly set up your business manager. So I'm gonna head up into our demo business manager here. So you're gonna wanna head into business info and just add your legal business name, your address, your phone number, and all information that you might wanna add in your business manager. Once you have that all completed, then you can head to payment method. And this is where you'll be able to add a credit card on file. So you obviously pick your country, your currency, and then just put in your credit card information. That's gonna allow you to spend money with Facebook, right? If you don't have that, well, you won't be able to, you won't go far, let's just say that. So once you have your payment method and you have your credit card entered into your business manager, then what you need to do now is verify your domain. So you're gonna click on brand safety, and we're gonna click on domains, and we're gonna add a domain, and we're gonna actually call this example.com. Now it's been added. For some reason, Facebook is always having an issue when I'm adding a domain. They don't refresh the page. So once you click add, just refresh the page, and then you should see the screen will change. There you go. So there's three different ways of verifying your domain. There's doing it through the meta tag verification, HTML file upload, and DNS verification. So I honestly recommend you do DNS verification. So that I'm gonna talk about that one. And it's pretty easy. All you have to do is log in into your domain registrar and then visit the DNS record section. And then you'll wanna add this TXT record into your DNS configuration, and you can just click to copy it. And then some of them will actually ask you to add a host field. So you can just use the symbol here if your domain host requires it. If you're using something like GoDaddy, and that's what I'm gonna show you, how to add this on GoDaddy. I've actually found an article that I'll share with you if you're using GoDaddy. But if you're not using GoDaddy, you're using something else, it doesn't matter. They are all pretty similar. You just need to really log in into your, again, your domain provider, and then you're gonna click on manage DMS, DNS, and then you're gonna wanna add a record, and then it's gonna be a TXT record. And then here again, like I said, in GoDaddy, they actually require you to add a host, and we're gonna add this symbol here. And what this means is just means that we're doing it at the root. So that's what it stands for. And then the TXT value, this is the code right here that Facebook is giving you. So you're gonna add the TXT value right there. And then TTL, you can just set it to, I believe it's like auto or whatever they have in the system. So you're gonna click save. And then once that's done, it's probably gonna take, here it says 48 hours, but Facebook here, they tell you 72 hours. So usually it verifies after 48 hours. So once that done, again, like maybe wait 48 hours and you can click verify. And to make sure and see if it's actually verified or not, did you see this little color here? It's actually gonna turn green. So when it's green, then you know it has been verified. So yeah, that is it. That's how you verify your domain. But I know we've talked about a lot of different things here, so I just wanna kind of recap what we've covered in this video. So obviously we've talked about the difference between Business Manager and Ads Manager, but I also showed you how to create your Business Manager. And then from there, we've talked about adding your ad account, adding your Facebook page, your Instagram page. And then also we talked about users, right? How Business Manager and you, your own profile, are two different things. And even though you might be the owner of those two things, you still need to add your profile and give your profile permission to change the ad account or the page or all these different assets. And then we talked about how to add your billing information, your credit card on file, so you can even run ads on the platform. And then I think is like one of the most important is to verify your domain, especially with what's happening with iOS 14 right now. Facebook really recommends that all businesses verify your domain. So yeah, that is it for this video, and bye for now.
All right, thanks Cedric for this comprehensive tutorial. If this video was helpful to you in any way, then please hit that like button, because then more people can find out more about this video. And if you have now set up your business manager, you want to start advertising, but before you do so, please one more step, set up your conversion tracking. We show you how to do this right over there. And I hope to see you over there. My name is Julian. Till next time.